Welcome to PSEMS. Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, we have started the chapter number 6th and 7th, where you have learned how to create the tables and how to create the links. Now, we are going to start the new chapter, that is chapter number 8, Frames in HTML. Frames are a way of organizing your website. They enable the user to divide a page into a number of rectangular segments for different purposes. Frames allow multiple HTML documents to be presented as independent windows within one browser window. This gives a greater flexibility to design and maintain your website. Now we are going to see how to create a frame set and how exactly it works and what are the points in that. We are going to see totally 8 points in this chapter, that is frame set tag, creating frames, frame set elements, rows and columns, then formatting frames using attributes, no resize, no frame, floating frame. All these points are discussed in this chapter. Now let's start how exactly this works. Frames are created with the help of frame tag. So now we will create one web page where we are going to create the frames. And we are also going to format it with different attributes of frameset. Now, HTML head and title. These all the tags already defined to you. Now we are going to start the different tags in this. The title we will give as a frameset 1. Then we will close this title tag. Then head close. Then we are going to start with the frame set tag. Till now you have started after head, body tag is started, right? But here we are going to start with the frame set tags, because frame set works before your body. So body tag is not going to be used here. Here we are going to use the frame set tag, and in that we are started the rows and columns will be we are going to use. What exactly the rows and columns are? Rows and columns are the division of your window screen. And here rows is equal to 20%, 80% means what? Here the whole screen is divided in 100%. So how much we want to divide our screen, we are going to initialize with the help of number of values we are going to place here. So rows equal to 20%, 80% means here I will create a two rows with the help of 20% and 80%. And then what I want to set in that particular frame, that can also be explained after the frame tag, frame set tag. Here below frame, frame border is there. So here we can initialize what we want in that particular rows. So in the first row, frame border will be is equal to 0, means what? I don't want any border for that frame. Then source pix3.jpg means in the first frame, that is a 20% row where I want to put a pic, that is pix.jpg, then name first frame, then scrolling. See here, the frame border, src, name and scrolling, these are the attribute of frame tag. Okay, so scrolling, you know that scrolling is used to scroll the page up and down, and if you want to set your particular frame, if you want a scroller for that, you can set as yes, and if you don't want, you can set as no. Now the next is frame set calls. See, in the first frame, in the 20% row one created, right, and one row is created with the 80% of the screen. Okay, so in the one row we have set the background image to pix3.jpg, and in the second row here we are going to create some more sections or some more divisions in that frame. So frame set calls is equal to 50%, 20%, 30%. It means here we are going to create 50% one column, 20% of one column and 30% of one column. Okay, so three columns here we are created. In that three columns, we are going to set different frame sections. Like in the first column, we are going to set frame1.html. I have already created one HTML file, which I will set to one frame in that. So I will give the source src. In this attribute, we can give that particular source file like frame.html. You can create your own HTML file and you can set that. And even you can set the images there. So first in that I will set the frame1.html, then I will give the name for that particular section, the second frame, okay. Then scrolling, as I already told, if you want scrolling then you can set it yes, or if you don't want you can set it no. For now I'll set is no. Then next we will set this frame border, and the source is set for the 50% of the column. Okay, now we will set for the 20% of the column. What we are going to do, frame border here is equal to, and then the value 1. It means what? I want to give a border to my frame. Okay, so the one value is placed. In the previous frame border we have set 0, it means I don't want the frame border. So it's up to you if you want to set the border or not. Then source pick 4 font jpg, means there is another image we have set in the second frame. Okay, then name third frame. Here name can be anything, whichever you want to give you can write it. For now I'm just using first frame, second frame, third frame, like that. If you want to use particular name to that particular frame, it's up to you, you can do that. Then the scrolling is yes. As I already told you that scrolling is used to set the scrolling property. Okay, if you want here, make it yes, no, then it is okay, make it no. Then frame border, these three different frame we have created for three columns. I hope you understood. Okay, then here frame border is equal to 0, I give, it means I'm not going to give the frame for the third frame, that border actually. Then source pick 3.jpg, then name is equal to fourth frame. Then scrolling is equal to, no, angle bracket complete, and then we'll make it as auto. Actually in scrolling we have three types of values, no, yes and auto. No means we are not going to give any scrolling column there, but if I want to yes, then I can add to yes. But we can also set to auto, means if it is required then we can set it auto. Your browser will automatically set if it is required any scrolling. Then we close the frame set and then we close HTML. Now we'll save this. Here we will type the name for our HTML file, frameset1.html. Then click on the save. Now we will see how to open that. Just double click on that file we just now created. Okay, I will open it in the Internet Explorer. Here you can see two different rows are created with the help of rows and column attribute of the frame set. 20% row and 80% row, and in the 80% row we have created again the columns with the help of column attribute of frame set, and even we have set the images for that particular frames. But here you can see we can change the size of the frames on the browser, right? So if you don't want to change the frame size, you can set it to no resize attribute of that particular frame. Then you are not able to make any changes in the browser of that particular frame set. So how to do that? You just have to type no resize in that particular frame, then that automatically happens. Okay, so here I will change the image which is not displaying, and then I will save it. Then here you can see, I will refresh it. So which image is not displaying in the second frame, it is now displaying, right? So like this we can change the, if any mistakes were happened, you can update it. And now you can see I am not able to move that particular frame, or I'm not able to resize that frame. Why? Because I set to no resize attribute of that particular frame. See, you can see here no resize option we are going to set. You can see in that frame border no resize is there, right? So we can give no resize option, set it there. Now we are going to see
for browsers that don't support frames. Many a time some of the browsers doesn't support the frames, so we have to give an alternative text if the browser doesn't support the frame. So here what I will do, I will start the body tag and then I will tell sorry your browser does not handle frames.
Then close the body tag, no frame tag and frame set tag, then HTML tag. Like this you can set it. Next option, and for that I will remove everything. Okay, only body and other tags will remain there. I will start with the last point here, that is floating frame, which appears as a separate box or a window within a web page rather than on one side or the top of or the bottom. A floating frame can be placed within a web page in the same way that an inline image is placed within a page. To create a floating frame, we just have to use the iframe tag. With the help of iframe tag, we can create the floating frame. Okay, so with the iframe we have to use width and height and source attribute. Height and width initiate the size of that particular floating frame. Then the source will define what exactly that floating frame will display to you. So you have to give the source also. Here I will type alignment also. Align attribute is used to align the particular that frame to your, where that frame should be displayed. So I will set to right. Then the source is equal to whichever particular image or HTML, whatever you want to set to that particular frame, you can set. Then save it. Once you have done that, you just have to close that iframe. Then save. I'll change the background color of that particular web page so that will be easier to you see how exactly that looks. So I'll set a BG color is equal to pink. Then save. Then refresh. The previous all the frames were removed, and here you can see one short frame which is actually the individual item which doesn't look like the frames of that particular window which are divided in rows or columns. It is actually the individual entity. We can create a frame just like your images, you can insert in the same way. Here we have inserted one frame which we set to right section alignment. I hope you understood what exactly the floating frame here. If not, you can ask the questions.
Here we have finished our 8th chapter. Now, in the next lecture, we will start the new chapter.
Till then, take care. Bye-bye.